Welcome to our virtual open house. I wanted to thank you for taking a few moments to connect with me. My name is Mr. Naylor. I'm going to be your son or daughter's math teacher this year. I actually wanted to first explain why I'm not available live. My son, Adam, is starting his first year at Lancaster Bible College, and we're actually moving him in today. So it's a busy day for me, but also a day that I definitely didn't want to miss. Getting him set up. Whether I'm live, whether we're virtual, whether we're in the classroom, one of the main things I always like to tell parents is that I love what I do. I like teaching, and I make this promise to you, if there's ever a time that I don't like it, I'm not going to do it anymore. I take my job real seriously, educating your children. I like to use the time in the classroom as best we can. Actually make a pledge to the students that we will never waste our time or do busy work, but we make use of the time, and I have a careful plan to make sure that we learn what we need to learn throughout the year, of course, with the mathematics. Beyond the mathematics, so the other thing I like to do in the classroom is honestly help students to become responsible young adults. That's another one of my main goals. I want them to be responsible. I want them to take ownership. I want them to advocate for themselves. I want them to make the most of their lives. And so I try to set up procedures that allow students to be responsible. Of course, this year with the uncertainty and maybe hybrid or maybe we're in the classroom, a great opportunity for students to advocate for themselves and be responsible. Maybe you're wondering, you know, what exactly is the classroom going to look like? Well, honestly, I want it to look normal. I want it to look as normal as possible. When students are in here physically, we're here to learn, engage, and be challenged. If they are home because it's hybrid or maybe because we're told we have to be home, I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to create videos of me teaching, interacting with them. And again, my goal is that they can have as normal as a year as possible. Some parents are wondering, what do we do if my student's absent? My answer to that is it's not a whole lot different than what I normally would have done. I have a website. It's MrNaylorsWebPlace.com. There you'll find the next 2.5 months planned out. So students can go to that website and they can see what we did. Also, we'll have Google Classroom updated with the same information. Now, my goal is to try to provide videos of our lessons, and I'll also post those links. They might not come right away because it takes a little bit of time to get that set up. But if a student is absent, they may also be able to find a video link of what we did. Worksheets are downloadable. All those things have always been available and will continue to be available this year. Now, specifically, students that are in my honors trig class need to be aware that there is a high expectation that they will be able to take the concepts and lessons that we learn in the classroom and extend them further on their own. What I'm getting at is that I definitely will teach them what they need to know, but I want them to learn to apply those concepts to new ideas. Often those problems can be more challenging. In the past, students may have skipped those problems or said, well, I'll wait and ask the teacher tomorrow. But I want them to try those problems. I want them to do them. And I find that when students start to do this, that they find that they can. So that's a little bit of a change with homework and assignments that they should expect to see these kinds of extension problems. And it's all outlined on the course procedures, which you can find on my website, or just ask your student, and I handed that out to them. Parents will also ask, what kind of calculator does my son or daughter need? The truth is they should have a scientific calculator, but a lot of times this year in trigonometry, students and parents are ready to make a little investment in a graphing calculator. I'm not requiring a graphing calculator, but I am suggesting that it might be the year that they want to invest. And this is a TI-83 Plus. You honestly can find them on the used marketplace for less than $50. And sometimes they go on sale for less than $100 new. If they don't have one and we need them, I have some in the classroom that they can borrow, or there are some phone apps that are similar that might help them to continued to work with us through the lessons and activity. So in closing, I will tell students, I'm an honest guy. I'm going to be honest with them about a mistake that I make. I'm going to be honest with them about what I'm thinking. I will be consistent with that. And in turn, I want them to be honest. I want them to be men and women of integrity. I want them to, as I said before, make good choices, but choices of integrity. And I believe that we're going to have a good school year. We're going to take it as it comes. We're going to learn. And as I said before, my goal is that we can make this feel as normal as possible, because I also want to see the students in the classroom. I've missed them. It's hard to believe that it's been about 6 months since we've been together. And so I'm ready, and I'm thankful that they're back, and I'm ready to work with you. I'm ready to work with them and help them in this journey. Now, I'm going to share with you a little video I put together that I sent to the students. It kind of just gives you a little more detail about some things that they can do. If you want to watch that video, that'll come next. Again, they watched it. They should have watched it before school started on maybe like Monday or Tuesday. So feel free to stick around and watch that. If you have any questions, you can still reach out to me, email, phone call. I still want to answer a question if you didn't get it answered by this recording. So please don't hesitate to do that. And thank you. Hello, everyone. My name is Mr. Naylor, and I'm going to be your math teacher this year. In just a few short days, I get the privilege of meeting you in person. But for now, I'd like you to watch this short video that's going to help you get ready, not just for the first day of school, but for our entire school year. Now, the first thing I'd like you to do is to sign in to our Google Classroom. I will use Google Classroom to post daily assignments, usually a week at a time. Now, if you're absent or a hybrid learner, then you'll be digitally submitting your work through the classroom. But if you're not absent, you're just going to turn in your work physically. Let me say that again. If you're absent or a hybrid learner, you're going to turn in your work through Google Classroom. But if you're not absent, you might just use Google Classroom as a resource for other links or just to see what we're going to be doing day by day. Now, in the case that Redline temporarily goes remote, then Google Classroom will be the main tool for everyone to access lessons, videos, and to turn in all assignments. Maybe you're wondering, will school close or will we learn remotely? Well, I have the same questions, but I want you to know that I'm going to endeavor to give you a top-notch experience. So whether we're physically in the classroom or we're learning online, my goal is that both those experiences are going to feel very similar. Hey, next, why don't you sign up for our Class Remind? I like to use this tool to send classroom communications. You can also text me. Yes, you can text me if you have a quick question or need clarification. Now, you may be wondering, where do I find this information? Well, it's on MrNaylorsWebplace.com. It's actually an additional resource for our class that's on the internet. Now, one of the main pages you'll find here are class calendars. These are another great tool to utilize if you're absent or if you just need to see what we're going to be doing for the next couple months. Also hope to be adding lecture video links to the calendars. There's a bonus problem of the month and some other helpful resources like the technology tool belt. Make sure you pay particular attention to my recommended phone apps, starting with the document scanners. Now, if you need to digitally submit your work this year, which means you're a hybrid or remote learner, you're going to simply take a picture of it using a scanner phone app. That way you'll be able to turn in one nice PDF. Now, I highly recommend that when you scan your work that you hold the assignment vertically. That way you'll minimize shadows and maximize clarity. The other nice thing about these phone apps is that they will be able to merge multiple pages into one PDF. Go ahead and spend a few minutes playing around with some of these apps and find one that you like. Lastly, you want to have a calculator. Now, if you're an algebra or trig student, you should have access to a scientific calculator. Something like the TI-30X. Some trigonometry students may also be ready to invest in their own graphing calculator. In that case, I recommend something like the TI 83 Plus. Now, calculus students, you're going to need a graphing calculator. If you're not able to secure these items, I do have some in the classroom that you can borrow. So if you want to get a little ahead of the game before coming to school in a couple days, sign into Google Classroom and complete that welcome back check-in activity, which is going to actually have you look over the course procedures paper. Now, don't just skim it. I want you to read it carefully because there's a lot of details in here about expectations, homework, and grading procedures. And it might be a little different than what you're accustomed to in some of your other math classes. Now, don't forget to check out Mr. Naylor's web place and get that digital tool belt ready. One last item, a basic spiraling notebook with plenty of blank pages is perfect for taking your math notes. I so much look forward to seeing you in a couple days and bringing you some sunshine, because you know what they say, a day without math is like a day without sunshine. We'll see you soon.